Breaking news in Victoria, where five people have been confirmed dead after a car crashed into a beer garden. This is where it happened just after 6 p.m. in Daylesford at the foothills of the Great Dividing Range, about an hour and a half drive northwest of Melbourne.
Witnesses say a BMW launched itself towards the pub's courtyard. It's a grassy area with a few picnic tables, nothing dividing patrons and the road. The Royal Hotel is a popular spot, especially on a Sunday night before what many consider an unofficial public holiday in Victoria ahead of the Melbourne Cup. Police say bystanders immediately rushed to help.
It's amazing what people do when others are injured, and from what I've been told, there's a lot of people that attended to those that have been injured and killed. So, you know, from that perspective, you know, it's been out of a terrible set of circumstances. You know, people have really done the right thing and tried to help.
Let's bring in Christine Ahern now, who is at the scene in Daylesford. Chris, paramedics have just spoken.
Yeah, we've just spoken to Ambulance Victoria on Today on Nine, and they describe the scene as extremely chaotic. Here on the scene this morning, we've just been allowed a little bit closer. So you can see just the number of police officers still here, a lot of tape around, and you can see that front lawn beer garden where this has all happened. You can also see a post that has been knocked down. What we know is that at about 6 p.m. last night, a 66-year-old driver from Mount Macedon was behind the wheel of a white BMW. Now, witnesses say that for some reason he accelerated like a rocket, and that is when he has ploughed in to that front lawn beer garden. Unfortunately, it was a beautiful spring day, so there was lots of people around. It is also an unofficial public holiday in Melbourne today ahead of the Melbourne Cup. So unfortunately, in this beautiful tourist spot of Daylesford, there was a lot of people around. As a result of this incident, five people have died. Two men, a woman, and also a young boy. They have died here on the scene. A teenage girl, she was taken to hospital, but tragically she also died. Ambulance Victoria say seven other people were taken to hospital. You can imagine the scene here on the ground, because there was four air ambulances taking four of those patients to hospital, three by road ambulance. Now that includes one boy who remains in the Royal Children's Hospital in a critical condition. At about 5 o'clock this morning, we have some vision of that white BMW actually being towed. So it stayed on scene here for some time while police tried to piece together exactly what happened. I've spoken to some locals this morning. They are in tears about what has happened in this popular tourist spot in Daylesford, about an hour and a half out of Melbourne. It's a tight-knit community, and you can imagine the horrific scenes that these locals have witnessed. But of course, this community did pull together, everyone rushing in to try and help and do what they could while they waited for emergency services to arrive. But as you can see, it's still a big police scene here this morning. The other side is still blocked off for some way, as well as police try and piece this all together. Carl?
It's truly awful. Mm. Chris, thank you.
Welcome back. Well, as we come back to you, we want to get an update on that breaking news in Victoria where five people have been confirmed dead after a car ploughed into a beer garden.
Joining us in Daylesford with an update is Regional Director at Victoria Ambulance, Trevor Weston. First on today, Trevor, good morning to you. What a horrible 24 hours. We know five people have sadly died. Do we have any update on the others at hospital this morning?
Yeah, good morning, Carl and Sarah. No update at this stage, but as you said, unfortunately, as a result of this incident last night, five people have lost their lives.
Yeah, it's such a tragedy. I know that pub well, Trevor. I've been there a few times. It's such a hub for the community and for so many people that would have been there interstate. How quickly were you able to respond to the tragedy?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, our crews were on scene shortly after 6 o'clock when we received the call, and our local crews, of course, were the first on the scene and confronted with what could only be described, I guess, as an extremely chaotic scene. And, of course, our thoughts go out to those families and to our responders who had to face this difficult challenge.
It's always difficult, and especially something of this magnitude. Look, members of the public were also there. Can you describe the way they assisted?
Look, from what I've been told by those crews on scene, the members of the public, those in the pub and those nearby, responded when they first heard the incident and provided what help they could to those who were injured. And I guess in doing so, did a fantastic job until our ambulance paramedics could arrive.
Trevor, do you have any further clarity on what may have caused this? We know that the driver was taken to hospital with minor injuries. Do you have an update on his condition?
No, look, I don't, Sarah, sorry. Only what we've heard earlier in the media.
Just given where it is and the severity of the accident, were the logistics hard for you?
Look, they were, as I said, we received our first calls for the incident just after 6 o'clock, and we had our local crews on scene very shortly after that. The incident was well resourced. We had about 7 ambulances and 4 ambulance helicopters dispatched and conveyed those patients off to hospital.
Pretty traumatic for your staff, isn't it, Trevor, what they witnessed?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, it's not something that we face every day, thankfully, and those staff that did arrive and did attend, we're following them up. We followed them up immediately after the incident, and we'll continue to provide that welfare and support for the coming days and weeks as it's needed.
All right. I appreciate you being on this morning. Thank you so much.
All right, let's get back to our top story now. And 5 people, including 2 children, are this morning dead. Several more are injured after a car ploughed into a busy beer garden northwest of Melbourne. Kimmi Moscicki was at the scene where the tragedy unfolded, and she joins us now. Kimmi, thanks so much for your time. We can't even imagine the horrors that you would have seen yesterday. Paramedics have described it as chaotic. Tell us what you saw.
Oh, it was totally chaotic. There was just bodies everywhere. Basically, we were sitting at the group of us sitting at the local RSL just having a drink, and we heard an explosion and, well, a loud bang. And we've turned around and seen a car hit a pole, and all of a sudden all these bodies just land on the ground just behind me here. And everyone just ran over just to help as many people as they could. There was a lot of people injured, but it was very surreal, and it was a terrible event.
It's really shocking, Kimmi. I can see that you're still trying to process what happened.
Sorry?
I can see that it's taken a toll. I mean, you're still trying to process what you saw.
Oh, 100%. And everyone that was there last night that helped or that witnessed it will be the same this morning. I had a lot of trouble sleeping last night because, you know, it's terrible. There's a lot of people that won't be going home to their families.
Yeah.
And it's just a tragic event and an accident that's happened, you know.
Yeah, and Kimmi, we know that this is a very popular pub in the region, right? So many, I've been there myself, so many Victorians gather around there, particularly on this unofficial sort of long weekend for Victoria. So there would have been more people there than normal.
Yeah, and it was a beautiful night as well. So absolutely, the weather was perfect to be out and, you know, have a drink or have something to eat. And it was about 6 o'clock. So, you know, it would have been about dinner time for some people as well while they're up here. So, yeah, there was a lot of people around. And obviously a lot of people injured as well and killed.
Yeah, absolutely. We know police are still trying to piece together exactly what happened. Was there anything that you saw in the lead up to this that you can shed any light on?
No, look, I just saw it once it sort of it happened, if you know what I mean. And until the police actually do their proper investigation, we won't know exactly what had happened. It's just an awful, awful thing for everyone involved.
And it's also...
And for everyone in the town as well.
Well, that's right. I mean, what we've seen from the people in the town, as you say there, the community really coming together to do what they can here.
Oh, everybody was. Anyone, you know, even to the point where there was people that knew they couldn't, you know, help people that were on the ground, so they went and blocked off roads to try and stop any traffic coming in because it's... one of, you know, what we'd call one of our major intersections here. So everybody just sort of, it was amazing to see that everyone just sort of took their place and worked together to try and save people and keep people alive until emergency services turned up.
And how are you and everyone there today?
No, oh, it's sad. It's doesn't feel real, but it is.
Yeah, it's awful.
It's a sad day.
Yeah, it really is a sad day, especially for such a tight-knit community. Kimmi, thanks so much for joining us this morning. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Thanks for your company this morning. First this half hour, that breaking news out of Victoria, where five people have died after a car ploughed into a beer garden, leaving at least seven others in hospital. Let's go live to Isabella Staszkowski at the scene in Daylesford. Isa, good morning. You've been speaking with locals. How are they doing this morning?
Brooke, good morning to you. I certainly have been. There is a lot of shock still in this community. This is being treated as a long weekend for many, so there are quite a lot of people here in Daylesford. Some of these local businesses are opening this morning, business as usual, but of course they're really feeling the impact. This is quite a tight-knit and small community, about an hour and a half out of Melbourne. I want to show you what it looks like here this morning. You can see that orange tarp is still across the front here. Plenty of emergency services, police officers and some first responders still here as well, just in front of the Royal Hotel. That is, of course, where we understand that 66-year-old man, that BMW, ploughed into the beer garden. I want to show you a bit of Daylesford as well, Brooke, just to show you what it looks like here. It is an incredibly pretty town. A lot of businesses, a lot of cafes that will be opening pretty soon here this morning as well. But as you say, certainly this impact on the community will be felt for quite some time to come. We know that many people last night were speaking about this and the impact that they were already feeling, just that pure shock after what had occurred.
We saw the bodies like under tarps from like that balcony at work, and it was pretty sad.
Overall, really sad having people die in such a small town, and especially another road accident.
So unknown, it's so scary. It's really sad.
Of course, we know that five people have lost their lives. A number this morning are still in hospital. One young boy at the Royal Children's, we understand, is in a critical condition. So still a lot to come out of all of this. Brooke.
OK, thanks, Isa.